Oh, hello. What's your name?
My name is Aaron J.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good.
Where are you from?
I'm from Galway.
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 What do you do, darling?
I'm a songwriter slash rapper.
Oh. So do you write your own rhymes then?
Yes.
And are you writing about a significant other? Are you single?
I'm single, yeah.
Are you? Well, you won't be after tonight. Okay, well, are you going to rap for us tonight?
Yeah, I'm going to perform an original song. It's written by myself. It's called Show Pain.
I've been a songwriter for most of my life, I suppose. I only recently started to actually perform music. It'd be cool to see something completely different, you know, like a songwriter, not a rapper, like that jumps around the stage, but someone who can, you can listen to my songs and they'd be like, right, there's a lot of power here, there's a lot of passion, and that's what I want to show people, that like it's not just all an image. Today I will be performing my own original song called Show Pain. It is about depression and anxiety. It is written from my own experiences. Growing up wasn't the easiest. And my mother was addicted to drugs for quite some time. Bad experiences shaped me and defined me. Being homeless for years is a big, big issue. It was just mostly B&Bs, hostel to hostel, parks, anything at all. Yeah, it was. It was hard. It was hard. Writing for me was an escape for me, because if I didn't have writing, I probably wouldn't be here today. And that's just being true. I want other people to hear the song, and maybe I could be a voice for people who are afraid to speak up. My only advice to anybody out there is don't try and be someone you're not. Be yourself and just talk to people. It works.
Every day that I'm okay, hope the smile on my face doesn't show pain. It doesn't show pain. This is for the ones who were brave, the ones who gave up but you chose to stay. I'm done with feeling fed up, man, it's hard to keep your head up. In my darkest times as my depression developed, and then I wanted to die, I wanted to escape. Wipe the tears from my face and I'll just run away. Embedded in my mind when my fears run deep, I might be strong, I got memories of being weak. I say that it's nothing and it doesn't mean a lot. I say I'm okay when you know I'm clearly not. I'm giving you a warning, I'm sick of the performing. I cry at night, man, just a smile in the morning. Depressed, sad, lonely and confused, angry and I'm mad, but I must have all bruised. That's what my depression is, terrified to always live. Every time I break down, they tell me to build another bridge. Tell myself that I'm okay, put a smile on my face, doesn't show pain. It doesn't show pain. Hey, I tell myself every day that I'm okay, put a smile on my face, doesn't show pain. It doesn't show pain. You're young and you shouldn't be confused. You hate the fact is that you're always in this mood. Please, dude, someone needs you. And if you open your eyes, let them see you. But now you're putting in the effort, but you should have known better. Smile on my face ain't nothing but pressure. You won't be here forever. But what you gotta remember is what you gotta remember is be strong, don't be weak. Stand up, find your feet. Be that person that you wanna be, the person that you wanna see. Remember this, man, the person I'm talking about, that is me. Tell myself that I'm okay, but the smile on my face doesn't show pain. It doesn't show pain. Hey, I tell myself every day that I'm okay, but the smile on my face doesn't show pain. It doesn't show pain. It never shows pain. Thank you.
This one hit me. I'm a mother of a kid with depression. It's a brutal thing for anybody to have to go through, especially a child who thinks that they're alone.
I wouldn't be here today if it wasn't for that song, myself.
I appreciate that.
Thank you.
Denise, Do you know what? I've said before, I struggle normally with rap music because I can't understand the lyrics, but I understood every single word of your performance. Everything just got me right here. I absolutely loved it.
Thank you.
Louis.
I just wasn't expecting that. It was quite incredible. You've definitely got something special.
Thank you, Louis.
You're very brave and you're very honest.
Jason.
Yeah, you're representing a lot of kids and young people up there, so, I mean, I loved it. I thought you were brilliant. You're a brave, beautiful person. Well
and
done.
And you're hot. Is he not hot, ladies? I mean, come on. Let's vote. Louis.
100% yes. You deserve it.
Denise. Yes. Jason.
Yes!
I think you know you got a yes from me, darling. Unconditional!
Thank you guys so much.
Me too. I'm a traveling musician. I'm based from Melbourne.
I like risks. I like to push the boundaries. 15, I left home. There's not many kids that leave their parents and their home when they're that young. But I wanted to earn the right to be a man by my 18th birthday. I wanted to go broke and I wanted to starve. And there are many times I've eaten out of a trash can. There's times I've drank water out of puddles off the side of the road just to get through, you know. Maybe a bad, bad thing. My folks played in countless bands. One of my earliest memories was sleeping in a Fender Stratocaster case backstage. And the smell of backstage is something I'll never forget.
Bring out our next contestant!
Yeah, come on! Come on!
Here he comes.
Oh my Jesus!
Hey man!
How you doing?
All right, what's your name?
My name's Dean.
Dean. How old are you, Dean?
I'm 22.
And where do you come from?
All over the place.
Oh, don't we all?
But I'm based in Melbourne at the moment.
Okay. Melbourne. So what do you do for a living?
I play. And no matter where it is, I try and play five nights a week. I had a back injury 12 months ago and I can't really do too much now, so this is what I do.
What happened to your back?
I was carrying an amplifier and walked through a doorway.
Wow.
Oh. Lots of pain.
Yeah, okay.
Ouch.
What are you going to sing for us today?
It's an old one, Betty Davis Eyes.
Yeah. Hey. Good luck, mate.
Cheers.
Oh, man, he's got his pick right there.
Oh, she got it. Oh, she
sheet out here.
There is no question you have talent, ability, feel. You've got, you know, like the late, great Michael Hutchence, you've got star quality, that mystery. I loved every minute of it. Thank you for coming to the X Factor.
Thank you so much.
I truly believe that everyone in this country is going to absolutely fall in love with what you do.
Thank you so much.
That wasn't a good performance. It was one of our best auditions ever.
Thank you. Lucky I don't wear a hat or it wouldn't fit on my head anymore.
You are rock and roll.
Yeah.
If I was with my friends and we saw you walking down the street and they would say, like, who's that dude? I said, that's rock and roll. That is rock and roll going to Starbucks.
Yep.
That was electrifying. I don't know what to say.
Okay. Dean, we got a vote. You need three yeses. It's a yes from me.
Hey!
Yeah.
A huge yes from me. It's a yes from me.
Someone need to check your passport because you are out of this world, man. Yeah, you are something else, man. You got four yeses. Welcome to boot camp.
Thank you very much.
Hi, guys. Hi.
The name of the band?
Luminites.
Luminites.
And you're from?
We're based around the M25.
Okay.
What, do you live on the hard shoulder?
Literally.
How are your stickers? Would I take them?
You take them.
I want them.
I'm Ben, I'm 19.
I'm Steph, and I'm 18.
I'm JJ, and I'm 18.
And I'm Corey, and I'm 21.
So where did you meet?
I bought them on eBay.
You bought them? Very chibo.
We've been together as a group for about 2 years now. When we all met, we was all doing totally different things. If Steph and myself were in school, Ben was busking on the streets, and Corey was a wheel mechanic.
Tires on wheels.
He's a pro.
Yeah, we just gig as much as we can. We've done empty pubs, we've done unis, we just go wherever.
School halls where the kids just didn't want to be there and we're like, come on.
We're used to just literally singing for our dinner.
Because right now we're pretty broke.
Squeeze. Oh, this is definitely going to be the biggest gig for us. We just want to show everyone just exactly what we can do.
Okay, well, best of luck.
All right, you ready?
Let's go.
Those things you're doing to me, they hurt so bad.
great. Well done, guys. Okay, let me go to Alicia.
Well, you're a ready-made band. You're fresh. I love the blend and the chemistry between you. You are solid. The beatboxing is wicked. Your voice is beautiful. Luminites, it was amazing. It feels unique. And the harmonies, perfect. It was absolutely a brilliant, brilliant audition.
David, what is there not to like about you? Fantastic song, you're all brilliant musicians, you're all very easy on the eye as well, in your own ways. No, you're fantastic. I didn't mean you so much, actually. No, you're like ready-made stars.
The song choice was absolutely genius. Genius. Your vocals were outstanding. It's very cool. By far the best audition we've heard today.
Okay, we're gonna take a vote.
David, yes or no?
Guys, it's a yes. Alicia.
The easiest yes today.
Definitely a yes from me.
Four big fat yeses.
Good.
She's so pretty. It's sort of unbelievable.
I can't take my eyes off her.
And her voice.
Voice is gorgeous.
So cute.
Do you know what? I don't think you could get better comments than that, could you?
Oh, no. We're delighted, man. We're absolutely over the moon.
You should be.
Hey, well done.
Go celebrate.
That was sick. So, best audition of the day.
My name's Owen Campbell. I'm 28 years old. I'm based in Canberra when I'm in the country, but I'm not here much very often.
Over the last 7 years, Owen has hardly been home for more than a few days at a time.
I've been touring in Europe and India and a lot of far-flung places. By touring, I mean busking on the street.
Armed with his guitar and his songs, Owen has taken to the streets of the world, performing to get enough food and lodgings to take him to the next town.
How much I make in a full session busking, well, that's, not good.
You stay here and look after the house.
I came on Australia's Got Talent because Australia's my country and I want to play music here.
But for someone unfamiliar with Australia of late and even more unfamiliar with Australian TV, today must be rather daunting.
I'm always nervous when it comes to performing. You hear a lot about the judges, obviously, so I'll just go in and do my thing and hopefully come out for the best.
Performing on our stage is a long way from busking in the cold railway tunnels of the world. So it seems Owen doesn't quite know what to expect from our infamous three.
How are you, mate? Where are you from?
Oh, I'm from around Canberra, mate.
Oh, lovely.
Good to see you, Carl, by the way.
Yeah, well, that's...
Kyle,
that's,
sorry.
Wrong name, that's all right.
Oh, now, hey.
I wouldn't mind, but it's written in front of you.
Is it?
No. How'd you check in, though?
How are you, judges? Danny, pleasure as always.
Hello.
Now, fellas, this is a non-smoking building as well, so just remember that for when we take off.
That's a good start, mate. You're on a flyer at the moment.
Well... Do you want me to get into it?
You better.
Okay. This is a tune of mine, friends. We'll pretend the judges aren't there for a little while and I'll just entertain you lovely folks.
Ooh.
Righty, is ready. It's called Sunshine Road.
What do you say about the judges?
We'll pretend we're not there. They're not there.
Tell you what I need. Well, I don't need much. I don't have much. You're sitting down a dark road. You're sitting down a dark road.
sitting in a raincoat. Oh, but Lord, I need just one thing, and it's a little bit of your love. Every rainy day I know, won't you let me rattle them bones?
Owen, lovely, very good.
Thank you,
very
Kyle.
Enjoyable, very enjoyable.
Cheers.
Why did you come out and try and make an enemy of us before singing?
No, I didn't make an enemy of you guys.
You know that it's only the three of us that can decide whether you go through. You can impress everybody, but it's down to us. And that was a pretty stupid thing to do, because part of being in this industry is you've got to have smarts as well. At the end of the day, okay, you need us to say. Do you want to let me speak? Do you just want to keep talking, or do you want us to actually speak to you?
Okay, boss. Okay.
Are you actually that cocky? Because you are very talented. You're gonna be the most talented guy in the world, and if you act like an ass, people won't like you.
Well, my aim isn't to be in a boy band, Chief.
Well, I'll tell you what. Here's a big lesson learned from you. It's a no from me.
Okay.
You know what? You're probably one of the most talented people that I've seen come through this, but you got the worst attitude ever.
Okay. Oh, I
and
get
it's
that.
A no
I
from
appreciate
me,
that.
Just on your attitude.
I can appreciate that. Thanks for
sure you can.
Your honesty.
Okay. My turn. I think you are excellent. You are cocky though. You are a bit cocky.
I do. Apologise if I did come across like that.
Well, you just... did.
He's got talent!
I want you to get into this competition because I want you to then have the newspapers of this country and the magazines writing complete and utter lies about you and see how you handle it, because that's what happens to us. So it's a yes from me. Because you're talented, right? Because you are talented.
Thank you.
Let the woman think.
Just say yes!
Owen, there's people who perform for a living, and if they want to take it to the next level, they come on a show like this because it's a platform and an opportunity. At 28, why is it that you're that talented and you haven't made it yet?
Because I've been... enjoying the process of travelling, really.
I have to judge you on talent and personality, because it's talent and personality that will win this. And on tonight's performance and everything, I would have to say it's a no.
Okay, next.
Dude, what happened? What was that all about?
With one of the most awkward and uncomfortable auditions we've ever seen on this show, Owen leaves with guitar and pride in place, but uncertain of exactly what he did wrong.
I'm only joking, you know. But, yeah, maybe I've got a bad attitude. See ya.
Hey guys. How are you doing?
Do you want to introduce yourself?
My name's Ricky. I'm from Southwest London.
Yeah.
And I have my beautiful family watching me. I've got my daughter. We just had a baby. She's 6 months. Hence why I've got quite a hoarse voice, because I'm no sleep, so.
What's her name?
Baby Star. And Heavenly is the older one. She's 10.
Heavenly and Star.
What are you going to sing for us today?
I'm going to sing Sam Cooke, Change Is Gonna Come.
Okay, big song.
What does that song mean to you?
I was actually, without going into it too much, I was homeless for 8 years. So I really needed a change to come. Mm-hmm.
My name's Ricky, I'm 36 years old, and I'm from Southwest London. Life before I met my partner wasn't great. I was homeless for about 8 years. Grew up, was on my own from sort of like 16. Now I've met my Alicia, we just hit it off. We just had this great chemistry. She's given me two beautiful children, and she's given me my smile back. And they have just changed my life to the point that I didn't think I ever saw anything this beautiful and this amazing. And now this could be an opportunity where something could actually be good in our lives and we can actually have something.
So have you tried out for anything like this before?
I haven't.
Okay, good luck.
Nobody else in this audience knew that other than you, lad. That was an unbelievable audition.
Not only are you rocking the man bun, but you're rocking Wembley Arena right now.
Wow.
Ricky, your voice is so strong and your personality is so strong, and I'd like to see so much more from you, so.
Thank you, guys. Thank you so much.
The point when it almost fell apart is the point where I really, really, really liked you, because you picked yourself up. This is why we make the show, genuinely, to find people like you.
I'm going to kick this off. It's a yes from me!
It is a yes from me.
I think you've just changed your life today. I really do.
Thank you.
And obviously it's a yes.
You got four yeses.
Thank you.
Oh, I need a hug, baby.
Hi. What's your name, sir?
Robbie Hance.
Can I ask how old you are?
26.
And how long have you been performing music?
Since I was a kid. I'll stand in the middle of the street and I'll sing. And it's the every second thought, you know?
And where do you live, Robbie?
Everywhere.
What do you mean, everywhere?
My current status at the moment is I am homeless.
Ah, okay.
I've been homeless for about 6 years on and off. Two nights out of every fortnight, like, I'll stay somewhere, like a friend's house or something. But the rest of the time, yeah, just kicking out on the street. I sleep in doorways, alleyways, just trying to keep dry. As a child, I felt like I was a big burden on people. I grew up in a single mother family. She had three jobs that she used to work every week. You know, it took its toll on her. So I was put into care at 13 years old. I never really gelled with any of the families or any of the people that I got with. And so it was easier for me to just shut myself away and just put my brain into the things I love to do. I have always sung. I don't think there's anything else in my life that I do with such, you know, such passion. This competition is obviously a big thing. It could add the element of security. It could change my life, yeah, definitely.
You've obviously had a difficult life. Has music helped you?
Yeah, it showed me that I'm worth a little something.
Okay. What are you going to sing for us today?
Damien Rice, Coconut Skins.
Okay.
I hope he's going to be good, do you?
Robbie, good luck.
Now you can hold her hand and show her how you cry. Explain to her your weakness so she understands. Then roll over and die. You can break decisions before you crumble up inside. Spend your time asking everyone else's permission. Then run away and hide. You can sit on chimneys, yeah. Put some fire up your eyes. No need to know what you're doing or waiting for. But if anyone should ask, tell them I've been licking cold coconut skins. We've been hanging out. Tell them God just dropped by to forgive our sins and relieve us our doubt. Oh, now you can hold her wrist, but your basket has a hole. You can lie between her legs and go looking for, tell her you're searching for her soul, yeah. You can wait for ages, watch your compass turn to cold. But time is contagious, and everybody's getting old.
Thank you.
Okay, Rita.
What do you feel like when you listen to music?
You know, when you listen to music and when you listen to that song of the time and the place where you remember that song and it creates the scene?
Yeah.
That's what it does.
I think you are more than capable of doing that for other people.
Talisa.
Robbie, I am really glad that you came today. You look like someone that's been lost for a while and I think you've lost your confidence in your skill and I think you need to realise the potential you have and how good you are.
Yeah, Robbie, I think you're a very talented guy. But I don't think you've had a break in life, you know, and I think you absolutely deserve that.
Robbie, I think you've got lots of talent and absolutely zero confidence, and that's the only thing to work on from my perspective.
Robbie, we're going to vote right now. Louis.
Robbie, I think you're talented. And I'm going to give you a chance and I'm going to say yes.
Robbie, I am going to say yes.
Thank you, Teresa.
Robbie? I say yes.
Robbie, you've got four yeses. You know I'll be. Well done.